bring up a little bit of joy.
Nothing says joy like being smalls.
I was recently told that every day is a gift. If that is true, most days would be that GameCube game your grandmother got you, even though you only had an Xbox. So. She just skipped my high school graduation and made my mom's childhood live in hell. So, so recently, New York passed this new affirmative consent law. And it's like the most pioneering one in the nation. It says that, like, even if you're like having sex and you're both consenting, you need to get like continued consent throughout the interaction. And it's like, I love that. But that poses a lot of problems for me. And let me explain. Okay, so I'm gonna set the scene for you, okay? To appeal to 11, Spotify is playing a mix of Marvin Gaye and the Moana soundtrack. But I need some sort of witness that it actually happens. I am moisturized as hell. So anyway, the fornication situation is going down. And in order to comply to the law, like I assume, like you go on at it and they'll just whisper, "Is this okay?" And she's gonna respond, "Yes, just okay." I'm from there, like, it's done, like, get out of my room, like, Nick, come out from under the bed, let's play Yu-Gi-Oh! This night is shot to shit. So anyway, like, when I think about, like, sex, I think about the last conversation I had about sex before going on to college. It was with my dad and my mom, and what happened was, my dad had bought me a box of condoms, all optimistic. But anyway, he gave them to me while we were out to dinner. He like slides them across the table, and then he goes, "Those should last you about the first week." We're like teasing my mom about this, and whenever we start to tease my mom about anything related to that subject, it always ends with her reminding me that my conception was a happy accident. Before going out to college. The first conversation I ever had with my mom about sex was in the first grade. So, part of that, I had like a general idea of what sex was from James Bond movies. I didn't know much, but I knew it was like correlated with like alcohol and espionage. Both of those had to be when you had sex. But, so, I point blank asked my mom in the room, like the parking lot of my sister's middle school, waiting to pick her up. I go, "Mom, what's sex?" And fuck that sugarcoating bullshit. My mom gave it to me straight. She goes, "Well, Dan, sex is, you know, penetration of the genitals." And she went on for about 30 seconds. I'm not saying I wasn't, like, emotionally ready for this talk, but 4 hours before, I had cried because the cafeteria ran out of strawberry milk. Where if someone asked me if I believed in Santa Claus, my answer was agnostic. But asked me what sex was, I should have drawn him a fucking diagram. Anyway, you know, sex is great, but you know what's also great? UNICEF. So, I did the UNICEF show. It was a lot of fun. I was really drunk. I was drinking for two that night. Me and the entire continent of African children who cannot afford $3.40 from Rams. always thinking about you guys. Prior to that, like, my only interaction with UNICEF had been with, like, Trick or Treat for UNICEF. I don't know if any of you, like, know what that is. It's like, you go door to door, and they're like, orange UNICEF house to collect money. Like, I didn't do that because I didn't want to leave sports early to go to CCD. I had friends growing up. But, anyway, I never did anything with UNICEF. I did a lot of work with this organization called Stop Hunger Now. And what Stop Hunger Now was like a meal packaging event. You'd go and package like thousands of events to feed people abroad. And every like 3,000 meals you packaged, you'd get a giant gong. And that like really confused me. It was like feeding starving people alone like wasn't enough to get people there. They needed like a freaking gong. Have there ever been like a car ride conversation where it's like, hey Bill, I think we should go to this really cool meal packaging event. You know, like we're saving hundreds of lives. He's just like, ugh. She's like, there's gonna be a gong. He's like, turn this car around. It really like got me thinking, like, if you live in Africa, you don't get to have a food allergy. I'm like gluten intolerant. It's like, you don't get to eat. With that, I'm gonna leave you guys. Thank you.